China amazes the world with this insane water project in the desert. In Western China, another engineering wonder has come to life. This is the Badain Jaran Desert. Home to some of the tallest dunes on Earth, some reaching a height of more than 500 meters, this is a dry place. The sun is merciless and there's no shadow anywhere. And yet, China wanted to build the largest water reservoir ever built on the continent in this place, by hand. I hear you. Why would you want to dig a large water reservoir in the desert? Many people will think this is an unrealistic fantasy. In this video, we will find out all about it. So grab a cold ice cream and join us on a mind-blowing journey in the hot desert. Living in the desert. With its many completed infrastructure projects, China has earned the nickname Infrastructure Madman. While the country's infrastructure has certainly improved dramatically in recent years, some of China's largest infrastructure projects were actually constructed decades ago. As early as the beginning of the last century, local people in the north of China desperately wanted to build a water reservoir. They were surrounded by two huge deserts, the Tengger and Badain Jaran Desert, and water was very scarce. Even in the wet season, the people's domestic water could not be guaranteed because of the lack of irrigation water. However, at that time, China did not have the strong infrastructure and economic strength of today, and could not provide much help to the local people. China was unable to avoid the many heavy construction machinery that was necessary. For more than 40 years, the local people did not fulfill this long-cherished wish, but the problem they faced grew more urgent by the day. The problem. Desertification has always been a major problem in China. It threatens the country's ecosystems and way of life. The worrisome annual expansion rate of over 3,000 square kilometers and the astonishing total area of over 700,000 square kilometers already affected by desertification call for continuous action. There is more than one factor at play here. Desertification is caused by a number of factors, including deforestation, poor land use, overgrazing, and climate change. This has consequences for agriculture, wildlife, and human settlements as once productive places become deserts. The effects are widespread, causing problems for millions of people, such as land erosion, depleted water supplies, and increasing air pollution. Once a reservoir of this size is built, it opens up vast opportunities for revitalizing otherwise desolate areas. The ability to irrigate a vast area of 900,000 mu, which is about 60,000 hectares, has the potential to bring new life to an otherwise lifeless desert. It will unquestionably alter the landscape, ushering in a fertile and luxuriant area that was previously unthinkable. The significance of the reservoir goes far beyond what you can imagine. Agriculture and farming in the area can completely transform by its ability to deliver water over such a large area. Once barren land can support lush vegetation and rich harvests thanks to an influx of nutrients. Surrounding communities will experience a dramatic improvement in their standard of living as a result of the increased vegetation. So, when did they start building this huge project? And how did they do it? Project in the Dunes. In 1958, only until after the founding of New China in 1949, construction of the Hongyashan Reservoir finally started. Over 180,000 workers were employed to build what was to be the largest artificial desert reservoir in Asia in a couple of years. Little did they know at the time, the project finally took them over 40 years to complete. Due to the lack of good machinery, the reservoir was dug out with hand tools one by one by a large number of local people. For the sake of a happy life in the future, the local people brought their own. With tools and daily dry food, they used their hands and sweat to build the dam of the reservoir, little by little, on the construction site. The harsh weather conditions were a major roadblock as they put the strength of the employees and the construction materials to the test. The work continued whether the temperature was 100 degrees or minus 40 degrees. But where did all the water come from? After all, we are in the desert here. Well, the main water source of the reservoir came from the Xiang River, which originates from the Kilian Mountains and flows northeast toward the Gobi Desert. However, when building the reservoir, engineers diverted the Xiang River to collect as much water as possible, ignoring the issue of protecting the ecological environment. This led to a rapid decline in the flow of the river and the upper reaches of the river, eventually stopping it flowing. In less than a year, the nearby lake dried up. Because the local restoration ability is poor, the vegetation could not be restored, and with the soil layer being very dry, it exacerbated the desertification of the land. Seeing the evil consequences of building the reservoir, many regretted it. Therefore, reducing its harm to desert areas is a top priority, and research experts believe that the restoration of the ecological environment of the reservoir can learn from the experience of the closure and diversion. Fortunately, after hard work, the local ecological environment has now been restored. Water from the same source can now flow in different directions so that the flow does not dry up, and it can also store water for the reservoir. After the water in the reservoir is saturated, people can turn off the water supply and divert the excess water to other areas so that the utilization rate of water can be maximized. Before the construction of the reservoir, the area was a desert with dry air and sparse vegetation, but since the reservoir was built, there are water and trees here, and the dam is surrounded by a green belt of 17.4 square kilometers with endless sand dunes behind it. Now the reservoir is irrigating more than 600,000 mu of local arable land, continuously providing water and supporting the survival and development of the oasis in the province. The reservoir has an area of 30 square kilometers and can hold up an immense 150 million cubic meters of water. Completion of the project. Although there were many obstacles to completing the project, China's dogged persistence paid off, and the ecosystem was restored. The completion of the reservoir was a game-changing event that has considerably enhanced the quality of life for millions of people residing in the region. Because to its development, a source of water that is dependable and has an ample supply is now available for use in agriculture as well as in residential settings. This has led to a revolution in farming practices and a rise in crop yields, which has ensured the population's continued access to nutritious food. In addition, the reservoir has spurred the local fishing sector, which has resulted in the creation of new opportunities for fishermen and an increase in the number of fresh fish that is available on the market. The tourism industry also has benefited from the existence of the reservoir. The reservoir's attractive surroundings and the variety of recreational activities it provides have attracted tourists from far for their visual value and recreational opportunities. Tourists that come to the area to go boating, fishing, or participate in other water-based recreational activities help boost local economies with the development of supporting industries such as hospitality and transportation. Future. The scope of this project shows how seriously China takes environmental protection. The country's dedication to sustainable growth and resource management is on display in its pursuit of a long-term solution. The reservoir is a shining example of human resourcefulness in making use of nature's bounty for the common good. It represents humankind's potential to adapt to dry environments and encourage sustainable growth, paving the way for more peaceful cohabitation with nature. In recent years, China has taken several steps to counteract desertification because of the seriousness of the problem. Large-scale reforestation initiatives, such as the Great Green Wall, have been established by the government to slow the advance of deserts. In addition, sustainable land management approaches, water conservation, and land reclamation are being used to lessen the impacts of desertification. China's desertification is a serious problem that needs to be tackled with a long-term strategy, international collaboration, and environmentally responsible methods. It jeopardizes ecosystems, food security, and water resources while exacerbating climate change. Combating desertification is crucial as it prevents soil erosion, conserves arable land, and curbs greenhouse gas emissions. China has implemented afforestation, water conservation, and sustainable land management strategies. Addressing desertification safeguards livelihoods, biodiversity, and enhances resilience, global collaboration is vital as desertification transcends borders. By sharing knowledge and resources, we can tackle this pressing challenge, protecting ecosystems, ensuring food security, and mitigating climate change are imperative for a sustainable future in China and beyond. Wow, that's one exciting Chinese megaproject. So, are you curious about other breathtaking projects? Like the impressive Baihetan Dam that also was built in China? Check out this video where we'll show you all about it and why its remarkable design created such a significant impact. We hope you'll like it enough to subscribe and like the video. Share your thoughts in the comments.